Travis with POSGuys.com. Today we're going to configure the DS228 to skip a pattern in the barcode. In this case, we're going to be skipping dashes. It is fairly easy to do with the 123 scan. All you have to do is to use the advanced data formatting, and I'm going to go through it on the monitor. So here I have 123 scan loading. I have my DS228 plugged in. I'm going to create a new configuration file. I have it connected via USB. You don't have to have it connected. You can have it working offline, and then you print some barcodes out and you can scan it with the barcodes, but it's a little simpler if it's plugged in. You select your release, and then here you are in the general formatting screen. So under modify data rules, by default you're going to look at the simple rules, and if you just want to send an enter key at the end or something like that, then you can set it here. But if you want to do something a little more complex, you go to this fourth option, Program Complex, and then you go to Advanced Data Formatting. Okay, so step one is to create a new rule. Under this new rule, you have some options here. I've showed in other videos how you use them. You can leave it all as default for right now, since we're going to make this apply to any type of barcode at any position. Under Add Action, you're going to go to Move to and Replace. Under Move to and Replace, I want to do all patterns. If you want to replace just the first instance of like a dash, you could do that, but I want to do all patterns. So click that. And what I'm going to look for is dashes. So I'm going to put the dash in there. And then I'm going to replace it with nothing. So I'm just going to omit all dashes. If you'd rather do something like replace with a zero, you could put that in here. You can also do longer patterns. So if you're looking to replace like a prefix, like if your barcode starts with 123 and you want to replace it with just a zero, you could do something like that. So it's there. So I'm going to go back to using a dash, and I'm going to go to save and add another. And what you're going to need to do is go back to the beginning of the barcode. So under skip, you're going to go to start. If you don't do this, it's going to run the pattern match and then send nothing. So if you ever get that blank, that's what's going to happen. Okay, so I go to save and add another. And then under send, you want to go to all that remains. Again, if you don't have this sent, then you won't send anything. It'll do the pattern match, it'll move to the beginning of the barcode, and then send nothing. So if you go to all that remains, then it's going to send what remains of your barcode. So click save. And there are my three rules. I'm also going to add one other rule. Under most commonly used, send, enter. And that's just to add the carriage return at the end of the barcode scan. Okay, so now we're done here. And I'm going to load it to the scanner. And we'll load it to all scanners. And it takes just a few seconds. And that's it, it's done. So now to test it, we're going to go to Chrome. And then under POSGuys.com/barcode is our barcode generator. And I'm just going to load a test barcode here. One other thing you'll need to do is you'll need to close 123 scan once you're done. So I'm going to save this to be used again. And now you can close 123 scan. If you have 123 scan open and you try to scan, then nothing will be sent to the screen and you'll think that you bricked your scanner. But actually it's just because 123 scan is open and it's captured the scanner. So turn 123 scan off and then you can test your barcode. So for some symbology, I'm gonna select code 128. My content, I'm gonna do 123-000-123. Gonna click generate. And it takes a few seconds to generate the barcode to the screen. In a few seconds, the barcode will appear. And let's test it. So I'm going to open up Notepad. here. And I'm going to go ahead and scan that barcode that I see on the screen. And scroll back up. There's 123. The dash was omitted. Then 000. The dash was omitted. Then 123. And you know, we can test it again. And there we go. So it works as described. So that's how you omit a dash from a barcode. And this works for any other pattern that you can come up with. For more information on the DS-228 or programming other scanners, please visit us at POSGuys.com. Thanks.